Okay, what is your name?
My name is Mohammed Sise.
And how old are you, Mohammed?
I'm now 15 years old.
Okay. When was your birthday?
My birthday is on Monday.
Monday. And tell me, where do you live?
I live at number 9 Waxalien, and I'm attending the school I'm attending is Batch Memorial Secondary School.
Okay. Now tell me, what is your medical problem? You have diabetes?
Yes, I'm a diabetes patient.
Okay. Tell me about your diabetes.
My diabetes, I have type 1 diabetes.
Okay, and what does that mean?
Type 1 diabetes, what does that mean?
Yeah.
That type 1 diabetes is just for the younger ones.
Okay.
And the type 2 is for the elder ones.
Yeah.
And people with type 1 diabetes, they depend on insulin.
Okay.
Forever.
Okay.
And people with type 2 diabetes, they depend on tablets.
Okay, excellent. And tell me, Mohammed, when did you find out you had diabetes?
I found out on...
How old were you?
15 years. On 2013.
And how did you know you had diabetes?
The last time, I am playing with my colleagues.
Yeah.
And I fell down.
Yeah.
I feel headache.
Yeah.
And thirsty. And I pass urine very frequently.
Okay.
But what caused that is, when I go to the village, I eat too much of sugar.
Okay.
I drink honey.
Oh, honey. Okay.
Yeah. And when I come to the city, that affects me.
Okay.
I never know that I have diabetes.
Okay.
And I pass urine very frequently.
Okay.
And when I pass urine,
yeah,
there are some ants went there.
Some ants, they like the sugar.
Yeah, like a sugar.
Okay.
And then I tell my grandfather, because he didn't know nothing, he said, maybe it is malaria.
Ah.
I said, grandfather, please take me to the hospital.
Okay.
He said, there is no money now. He said, please patient until next month.
Okay.
And I keep patient.
Okay.
When my uncles come, my grandfather explained to him how I feel. He said, let's go to the hospital.
Yeah.
And we go to the hospital in the Holy Spirit Hospital.
Yeah. Yeah.
When we go into the hospital, we meet Dr. Albert, the doctor of Holy Spirit.
Yeah.
He said, you need to be diagnosed and let's see if it's diabetes.
Yeah.
And Dr. Albert said, I suspect this boy. I suspect him that he has diabetes.
Yeah.
And my grandfather said, yes, let's scan him. And Dr. Albert took me to his office and do some scanning.
Yeah.
And later, he said that, I said that this boy has diabetes.
Yeah.
I said, my life is on suffering because now I have no money to buy medicine and I have diabetes. What should I do?
Yeah.
They said, there is a woman called Dr. Veronica. He helped children. Who suffer from diabetes. I said, I want to see this woman.
Yeah.
And they take me to Dr. Veronica.
Yeah. Yeah.
And he keep giving medication until now.
Okay. And tell me, Mohammed, you've been to your village and you've tried some medicine to try and cure the diabetes?
Yeah, because I went to the village last month and they give me some native medicine.
Mm-hmm.
And I came with it. I saw my grandfather. My grandfather said, maybe this can cure your sickness. I said, grandfather, are you sure you say yes? And I take the medicine. And when I take the medicine, I eat rice.
Mm-hmm.
Because the medicine, I mix it with the rice when I'm eating.
Mm-hmm.
And when I eat, I take the insulin. I feel like going off. I feel like going crazy.
Mm-hmm.
I said, this cannot scare me. Because the doctor said that diabetes will be forever.
Mm-hmm.
And the doctor tell me that if I keep taking my insulin, the diabetes will be controlled. And I tell my grandfather, I will never take this medicine again because it is native.
What did your grandfather say?
He said, He said, go on and tell the matron. And then I came to the matron, I explained to him. The matron said that it is true, stop taking that medicine. It is native. Just take the insulin. We will be better.
Tell me, Mohammed, have you been in a coma with your diabetes?
Yes, I'm going to coma. I've gone to coma 2 times.
Okay, what happened?
The last time, my sugar goes high. And I don't know that my sugar is where I'm in school playing with my colleagues. And I feel like going to coma and I fell down and I go to coma.
Why had you been taking your medication or had you run out or?
because we have a small health center in our school. They go and do tests. They say, oh, this boy have diabetes. They say, what happened to him? The doctor said that it's too much of sugar. They say, let's take him to the Holy Spirit. And when they take me, Mr. said, oh, this is one of my patients. She said that, oh, this is sugar. He tested me and my sugar is high, no reading, high. And they tried to give me insulin and I wake up. I asked the people, where am I? They say, you are in the hospital. I say, what happened? They say, your sugar goes when you are in school playing with your colleagues. I say, oh, I say, Mexican, thank you. I say, you are a good woman.
tell me, Mohammed, why did your sugar go high? Had you run out of insulin? Had you stopped insulin for a while?
No, because I did not have the machine to check. I will not go in to take insulin without knowing the reading of my blood sugar. That's why I said that, let me go to school first. This is the thing.
So are there times when you do not have your insulin? Are there times when for some weeks you don't take your insulin?
Oh, it is only when I go to the burial of my mother.
Yeah.
I stop taking insulin for 1 week.
Yeah.
7 days.
Yeah.
And then when I come to the hospital, when I check, the sugar is high.
Yeah.
I thank God when I do not go to coma.
Yeah. Tell me, what happened to your mother?
My mother, the last time, they called me here because I'm in school. They call. They say, oh, Mohammed, your mother is very sick. I said, oh, can I go there and see him? They said, no, you have taken an external exams. He said, don't come. He said, she will be all right. I said, okay, please take care of my mother. If I have finished my exams, maybe I will come if I have transport. And now, the next day, they call me. I say, oh, your mother is in the point of death. I say, what? I say, oh, you promised me that you will be taking a good care of her. Oh, what now? They said, oh. They say, go and tell your aunt that your mother is in the point of death. I run and tell my aunt. And we come to the machine here. And when we go to the village, oh, as we step our foot in the village, my mother's died. She passed away. And there is nothing that he left for us. We are three in numbers.
So you have a brother and a sister?
Yeah, because I'm the elder one.
Yeah. How old is your brother?
My brother is just 7 years old. His name is Abdul.
And your sister?
And sister is Aisha.
And how old is she?
He's 12 years. Because I can't read.
Yeah.
I can't read of him now. Because we stopped seeing for a long time.
Yeah. And tell me, who's going to look after your brother and sister? Who's looking after you?
Who is looking after them? Because the time my mother is alive, she's the one that's looking after them. But now they are suffering in the village. No one is looking after them. That's why I want to go to the village and collect them. If they come here, we sell and have food for it to eat.
So who looks after you here in Makeni?
Oh, my grandfather.
Okay.
But he has gone old.
Yeah. So what do you do for money?
What?
How do you manage for money?
Yeah, because the last time, the freezer just go off. They said, we need to change the fan of the freezer. I said, no. I said, this will be here because I have no money now. And the next day I admit here.
And how do you make money? You go after school, do you? You go and sell?
In the morning when I wake up, I wash my body. And because in the morning there is no money to prepare food. And I go to school. Even the last time, it is my teacher that has prepared food for me. I can't just remember her name.
Don't worry.
Yeah. He prepared food for me, and I thank him so very much. You see me, I like thanking people that do something for me. And when I go to school, when we off to lunch, because the woman that's selling rice there, it is not the rice I'm eating, he's selling. So my teacher take me to Adna supermarket here, because he's a good woman like you again. Because he's a good woman like you. And he buy me biscuits, some biscuits. Oh, I like that biscuit. It is called salted. And when we come from school, when I go home, because when I want to go to school, I put the freezer on. The water is cooling. When I come to when I come home, I just take the water, put in the cool man, and go and sell.
Oh, I see. So you go and sell the water.
Yeah. Whatever money I have, I buy bulgur rice and bring it at home. And when I prepare the bulgur here, I prepare here the rice. The rice is going to my grandfather, and the bulgur is for me.
Okay. So you earn the money by selling water to buy some food.
Yeah.
Okay. And tell me, what does it feel like to have diabetes in this country?
What?
What is it like having diabetes for you? Is it very difficult?
Yeah, it's very difficult. Mm. Because this sick, it's not for poor people.
Mm.
Because in this country, there are not people that have sympathy. Mm. There are not people that have sympathy.
What are you worried about the future? What worries you about diabetes in your future?
What I want to be in my future, I want to be a doctor.
Oh, good for you, Mohammed. Mm. And so you will be. And do you worry about your diabetes in the future?
Yeah, I worry about diabetes.
Yeah. What is it that you worry about?
Because the last time I asked Metron, I said, Metron, if I'd know anything about me, I said, Metron, if a person has diabetes, whether it's type 1 or type 2, he's keeping taking medication, but there is not correct food for him. What will happen to him? He said, oh, you're very brave boy. I said, this is a question for me. Because now, I'm keeping taking medication. Dr. Veronica sent me medication every time and every hour. I take it. But there is not correct food for me because I have no money. Because if I'm hungry, if a person give me mango, I should eat because I'm hungry. If a person give me tea or bread, I should eat because I'm hungry, because I have nothing to eat. I said, what will happen to me? He said, if your sugar goes high without the medication, see, one day you will go in coma and die. I said, oh, please help me because I don't want to die by now. I want to be a doctor in the future for me to take care of my younger ones because my father is not caring for me now and my mother has died last month. I said, please help me. He said, oh, he said, you have to thank Dr. Veronica because she's the one sending you medication every time. He said, you are a small boy. You were not able to buy the medicine. He said, you have to thank Veronica because she's the one that sent it for you. If you go older, you will manage for yourself. He said, now you have to be in a very critical condition because you have no money to buy food. He said, you have to keep it up.
And do you know, if you have diabetes for a long time, you were saying that you're worried about your eyesight?
Yes, because I asked me to last time the same question that I asked you, that is diabetes stealing people's vision? He said yes. If you don't take care of your body, your blood sugar, if you keep eating sugar every time with that medication, maybe one day you will get blind or paralyzed, your foot will not walk again. He said, please, Mohammed, take your medication. Take your medication. I said, I can't be a man without food. He said, if I keep taking the medication without food, that would make me go to coma. He said, you have to be... He said, I agree with you, Mohammed. I agree with you. Even the last time, she's the one that prepared food for me in the world. She said it to you the last time. She's the one that's preparing food for me.
Okay, thank you. And what is your football team?
My team is Chelsea.
Why?
Because they have good players.
Yeah.
The player that I'm supporting is Drogba.
Yeah.
Drogba. Because they win the cup the last time.
Yeah.
And I said, oh, because I'm in Liverpool, like Frank.
Yeah.
I said, oh, you boy, you are silly. I said, I will left in Liverpool, I will go in Chelsea because they are good players there. He said, oh, he said, left it me. He said, if you leave me here, he said, we will see. And then the last week, we win the cup, Chelsea.
Ah. Thank you, Mohammed. Bye now.
Yeah. Goodbye.